I don't know what's going on with our music. All right, but I think we can go ahead and get started. All right, good morning, everybody, and welcome to our Monday morning assembly. Today is Monday, September 19th, 2022, and we are ready to get started here. All right, so here we go. As usual, we start with our Pledge of Allegiance, right? So right hand over your heart, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all. And now in Spanish for our dual language program. Yo prometo lealtad a la bandera de los Estados Unidos de América. Y a la república que representa una nación bajo Dios, indivisible, con libertad y justicia para todos. All right, so let's get started, everybody. So as usual, right, our MacArthur Park positive student behavior expectations. Rule number one is to follow school and classroom rules at all times. Rule number two is to solve conflicts without physical or verbal violence. Number three is to help us keep our school clean, right? It's your school. So help keep it clean, right? Number four is report any bullying, harassment, or hate-motivated incidents. Rule number five is to display good sportsmanship on the playground. Rule number six is to always be on time and be ready to learn. All right, and of course our three B's, be safe, be respectful, responsible on the yard, right, and all other areas of our school. And did you know that tomorrow is already the 25th day of school? Wow, right? I can't believe it's been 25 days already. It seems like, it's going fairly fast, right? 25 days of school already. So tomorrow we celebrate our 25th day of school. So don't forget to wear your cheetah gear as well tomorrow. So if you have any cheetah gear, make sure that you wear it. All right, and we continue to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month. We'll continue celebrating up until October 15th. And of course, as we continue celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, don't forget to read books about prominent Hispanic Americans or Hispanics, right? In Mayan. Right, read about people in culture, in sports, government, or in history, right? So make sure that you are reading on Mayan. And just a reminder that our school-wide reading contest is continuing, and we hope that in October we're able to announce who the winner is or winners are for September, our September reading contest. Okay, let's go ahead and keep going here. Give me 1 second. We have some people waiting, so let me admit everybody. Okay, let's keep going. And also, we are learning about the Constitution as well, right? So today, we're just going to do a little refresher on what the Constitution is. Did you know that the Constitution is basically the guiding document for all laws here in our country? That's really what it is. It's a foundation for all the laws that we have here in the United States. Okay, and it's our most important document, our most important guiding document in our country. Okay, so we're going to watch a short video about the Constitution and just what it is. But before we do that, let me go over a few interesting facts about the Constitution. So, also Constitution Day, I don't know if you knew this, but Constitution Day is celebrated September 17th every year. It's the anniversary of the day that it was signed, okay? And it was ratified in 1788, which means it was put into law, right? And it's the world's oldest surviving written document, okay? Its first three words, we the people affirm, affirm that the government of the United States exists to serve its citizens, okay? And then another fact is that the U.S. Constitution has 4,400 words. It is the shortest written constitution of any major government in the world. Okay, and then, of course, because of his poor health, Benjamin Franklin, he needed help signing the Constitution. So as he signed, tears actually ran down his face. So he wasn't doing very well health-wise by the time he actually signed our most important document. All right. And then on November 26, 1789, George Washington established the first national holiday of Thanksgiving to give thanks for the Constitution. All right, so here's a short video that we are going to watch. Let me go ahead and play that for us, just to give you a little bit more background on what the Constitution is. Fifth graders, this is for you, actually, right? So make sure you're paying attention, fifth graders.
All right, here's a question for you. When's the last time you and a few friends sat down and tried writing one single document that would determine the way millions of people over hundreds
the audio is bad, right?
lived?
Yeah.
Document that would structure the government of an entire
Can we go back
nation.
Maybe to the previous slide and play it from there?
I don't think so.
Let's try it again. Okay, let's try this again, guys. If it doesn't work, it's okay, because I believe your teacher should have this resource and you can watch it on your own. So let's try it one more time.
Here's a question for you.
It's still jittery. No worries. Okay, so as I mentioned, the Constitution is the foundation, really, of every law that we have here in the United States. So every law that is written, every bill that is proposed here in our country, always goes back to the Constitution and what the Constitution actually says in terms of guiding laws and guiding bills to be passed in our legislative system.
All right, here's a question for you.
I have it playing over on my side. Do you want me to just play it?
Sure.
Okay.
Are you able to share your screen?
When's the last time you and a few friends sat down and tried writing one single document that would determine the way millions of people over hundreds of years lived? A document that would structure the government of an entire nation? Yeah, didn't think so. Lucky for you, fewer than 100 men took a crack at it back in 1787 on behalf of the United States of America, hoping to write one document that would contain in it all the laws and instructions for how our government should function. Now, don't worry, once they had their final draft, they did put it to a vote. There were 13 United States at that time, and at least 9 of them would have to ratify the Constitution, meaning they formally agreed to it, before it became official. And now, that single document, still known today as our U.S. Constitution, remains the ultimate law of the land, the most sacred code we have for how the government should look. Pretty impressive, right? I mean, no one's perfect, but hey, that we're still running things 230 years later means they must have done something right. Now, let's rewind a few years back to 1775, when the Second Continental Congress met in Philadelphia. Besides issuing the world-famous Declaration of Independence, that gathering of delegates planted the first seed of order for the new nation, which they hoped to defend from King George. That seed was a document called the Articles of Confederation, a plan for how the new U.S. government should operate, that powered the newborn nation through the Revolutionary War. Unfortunately, it had a major flaw. You see, living under a powerful king had caused the colonists a ton of trouble, so the Congress decided to give the central government, ours is in Washington, D.C. today, very limited power over the individual states. 9 of those 13 states had to give their approval before the central government could even pass a single law. See where this is going? The weight of the states overwhelmed the central trunk of government, and chaos erupted in newborn America. Having gone from a central government that was way too strong, as in the case of the king, to one that was not strong enough, Americans would need to find a balance, especially as new states joined the country in coming years. They needed a central government that could hold everyone together. And so, because gatherings of delegates from all the colonies or states for very long meetings had been successful in the past, our founding fathers decided to call yet another very long meeting in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, once again, called the Constitutional Convention. And 55 delegates from all over the states attended. And their original goal was to revise, not destroy, but revise the Articles of Confederation. But when they took the pulse of the document and thought it through together, they realized they'd be better off starting from scratch. So they torched it. And in 1787, they put their heads together to come up with something new. And here's what they decided. The central government would have more power over the states, but it would also be split into 3 different sections called branches. Each branch would have its own unique set of powers, and with the power divided 3 ways, the central government would never get too strong. The legislative branch, made up of 2 houses full of elected representatives from the different states, would come up with proposals for law known as bills. The executive branch, made up of the president and his or her closest advisors, a group called the cabinet, would receive those suggestions for law and either veto or reject them, or sign off on them, turning bills into law. Judges from the judicial branch would settle any arguments over how individual laws should be applied. They also reserved the right to overrule any laws that violated the Constitution. The way that each branch puts a limit on what the others can do is called the system of checks and balances. And as one further limit on the power of the central government, individual citizens are able to vote on their choice of representatives for the legislative branch and for the president in the executive branch. Now, the delegates at the Constitutional Convention knew that they weren't the only ones with good ideas, so they made it possible for future Americans to make changes or amendments to the Constitution. It would take a ton of votes to approve an amendment to the Constitution, but even so, the first changes were made rather quickly. In the year 1788, the Constitution had just been approved, and our central government met for the first time. The legislative branch that we call Congress started receiving suggestions immediately from the different states on changes they thought should be made to the Constitution. You see, a lot of people were still afraid that the central government would be too strong. Of all the changes suggested by the states, Congress voted to approve 10 of them as amendments to the Constitution. Today, we refer to these first 10 amendments as the Bill of Rights. They are a shield protecting you from mistreatment by the government. Among other things, they guarantee you, the individual, the freedom to believe what you want, to say what you want, to own a weapon if you want, and to be defended in court if someone accuses you of a crime. Without this Bill of Rights or the opportunity to create other amendments in the future, who knows if the Constitution would have survived until today.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Alvarez. Thank you for sharing that. All right, everyone. So that was just a little, a brief insight into what the Constitution is and how the, you know, how it's broken up into, you know, the three branches of government, right? Which is really how our country is structured.
All right, here's a question for you.
Okay, and then, you know, a quick reminder, we will be making a switch over to YouTube Live sometime soon. That we have another surprise coming to everybody in terms of doing this, going over to YouTube. A couple other things that we'll talk about, but just so you're aware. All right, and now this brings us to our Bravocados, our shout-outs for the week. So we want to give a big Bravocado to Ms. Perez and Ms. Villar for organizing our observance of Suicide Prevention Day last week. And also really for, you know, just the work in terms of mental health, right, that they really put into our school and their dedication. Okay, so big Bravocado to Ms. Perez and Ms. Villar. And then also Mr. Mario and the LAUSD maintenance crew, our workers, right, who repaired our broken AC systems. I know our NPR, for example, was out for quite a long time, and now it's finally nice and cool in there, so we are thankful to them. Room 101 as well, so Bravocado to them also. And of course, we're now finally also at our bucket filler winners for the week. So here are our bucket filler winners. In Ms. Morales's class, we have Marvin Calderon. We also have Herman De Leon in Ms. Izquierdo's class. Raimundo Garcia in Mr. Perez's class. Daisy Lopez in Ms. Morales's class. Robin Lopez in Ms. Tappy's class. And Shailene Villasaldo in Ms. Cervantes's class. So congratulations, guys, on being our this week's bucket filler winners. And make sure that we keep earning those bucket fillers. All right, and now we're at our joke of the week. So I don't know if you guys knew this, but we're celebrating quite a few things today. So we're celebrating 25th day of school tomorrow. We are celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month, right? We're also celebrating Constitution Day, right? And I don't know if you knew this, but today is Talk Like a Pirate Day. Did you know that? Yeah, it's one of those obscure, it's not a holiday, but it's one of those obscure things that people don't really know. But if you check, today is Talk Like a Pirate Day. So, in honor of Talk Like a Pirate Day, today we have a pirate joke for you. All right, so here's our pirate joke. Why couldn't the pirate recite the alphabet? Because he kept getting lost at sea. All right, terrible joke. Just as all my jokes, they're terrible, right? But, you know, they're fun. They're fun. Okay, so that's it, guys. Thank you for joining us for our Monday morning assembly. I love the hat, Ms. Alvarez. You should wear that more often. All right, everybody. Have a wonderful day today and an even better rest of your week. Bye now. Take care. Have a good one, everybody.